Terry Becherer went into business with his father, Elmer, when he was 14 years old. They started raising sheep on 7 acres of land. Today, they own Rocky Ford Ranch in Trenton, Illinois. In an area where land is at a premium, they have to make every one of their 40 acres count.
We started out in 1987 with 6 sheep, and now I'm running with my ewe lambs about 380 ewes in our breeding flock. So we've grown quite a bit over the last little over 20 years. But what really led us up into it was our forage program. And that's what allowed us to expand and go to the numbers where we're at. We got into a different market, so we had room to grow. Originally, my goal was always to run 150 ewes. And then with the market that we got into, I found that I could run a lot more and still do well. So I found a way to utilize our forage program to allow us to grow our numbers to where we are today.
They knew that a good forage program was critical to their success, but finding the right program took some time.
Our farm was an old dairy farm, and it was an 8-acre patch that they had planted to the old Kentucky 31, and I had used that lambed in the fall when they were on that pasture that had such thick placentas that my death rate was horrible. If we weren't there when the lambs were born, they couldn't break out of the sack. So then we went through the process and started using our annuals a lot more. But when we started using like the pen leaf, pearl millet, and the winter grazer rye, we had too much forage for the number of animals that we had. That's what allowed us to start growing. We started realizing what we could produce off of a 40-acre farm. And by doing that, I knew I had to get more animals to eat the forage because I was wasting more than I was grazing, which in most cases was a good thing to have too much than not enough. But we found that as we grew, it was easier to manage the forage with the larger numbers that we had because we could control it a lot better.
While they were having good results with the annual grasses, they were still looking for a permanent solution.
Then as we went along, a local guy from here, he kept telling me to try fescue, the MaxQ fescue, and we had old Kentucky 31 on our farm when we originally bought it, and that was a nightmare. So we tried it on about 2 acres, just for a little test plot. And then once it got going and we saw what it produced through our forage collection every month, because that's the research they did, they came out and we took a 3x3 square, we cut the forage, did a forage analysis on it, and then the guy that was doing the research could compute how much forage per acre was available. And that really started to open up our eyes. And then when we turned the sheep out on it, they ate it fine. So that was a big bonus, because when we had Kentucky 31, in the dead of winter, they'd eat it. But any other time, they would do anything they could to get out, and that was a nightmare fixing fence every day, and it just wasn't worth the aggravation.
The initial MaxQ test results looked promising, but for Terry, there was one ultimate test it had to pass.
The condition of our ewes is what I went by. When they were on Kentucky 31, they would go out there and they would eat enough to survive, is what I would say. So the ewes lost body condition. So I would either have to supplement them with a hay or some type of protein to try to increase their appetite. But once we went to the MaxQ, they don't refuse to feed. So they eat more, and then they maintain their body condition. So for us, it's not a matter of weight gain. It's a matter of not having weight loss. And our mature ewe flock runs on the pastures like that. There is no supplement when they're out there. They're on grass. I don't supplement them with anything else. So their entire body condition score is coming from the forage, and that lowered my cost of production. That was my gauge. My ewes stay in good shape, and I have good breed and conception rates, and I have really high multiple births. So that leads to my profitability, and that's what switched us.
And after the switch to MaxQ, the Becherers found even more benefits.
Pasture's always been a neglected resource on a farm. And if you're going to use improved products, it takes improved management. And that's where you really see the benefits. If you manage it properly, it pays 10 times better than the improved genetics they have in corn or anything else. You'll see that much more production. And it's there forever. People don't think anything about planting a corn crop every year. They stick all that money out there. But you plant this grass and manage it, it's there. And you don't have to repay that. So that initial investment is really a drop in the bucket because it's nominal. Once you make your switch and start to manage your forages, it's real simple. And it actually cuts down on your workload. It's so easy. Our winter feeding, whenever we move a 2-strand temporary electric fence, I can move a fence in 15 minutes and I can feed the sheep for the next 3 days. And then, I mean, I don't have to do anything else. And it's easier. It's cold. I don't have to go out there and sit on a tractor when it's cold. And the sheep are better and they're doing what they're meant to do. You know, they're out there making, harvesting it themselves. I'm not working, they're working.
For Terry Becherer, the MaxQ bottom line is pretty simple.
At the end of the day, I was cheaper grazing their product than I was somebody else's. Even though theirs cost more to start, it produced, it was money well spent. And it just had that much more production. We almost tripled the size of our ewe flock, and I'm still running on the same 40 acres. I'm trying to make money. When it costs me less, I feed them for less, that's my answer. So I it's a no-brainer for me. They outproduced, and it cost less in the long run. So I had a superior product that cost me less to feed it to.
Pennington, come grow with us.